We at the World Bank here in Kenya have successfully facilitated partnerships between the government and the agtech startups so that smallholder farmers in Kenya could leverage digital technologies and access high-quality inputs, extension services, and market linkages right at their doorstep. In Kenya, the World Bank Agriculture Portfolio has got two large national projects, the Kenya Climate Smart Agriculture Project and the National Agriculture Inclusive Growth Project, which are cumulatively investing $450 million and have a presence across all 45 rural counties in Kenya. These two projects have an outreach of 1 million farmers, and these projects involve organizing these farmers into farmer producer organizations and making investments across the value chain to enable them to access services and enhance their productivity and profit. So it's in this context that we wanted to bring in agtech startups, as the biggest constraint these farmers are facing is service delivery in the last mile. So we organized a challenge in April 2019 where we invited local Kenyan agtech startups to come and pitch as to how they can actually partner with the public sector and scale up innovations that they've already demonstrated. We identified 14 partners across the areas of productivity, market linkages, financial services, and data analytics. And at the end of this challenge, in partnership with Ministry of Agriculture in Kenya, we launched what is called the 1 Million Farmer Platform, a platform which will enable the agtech ecosystem, other development partners, and the government to come together to provide last mile services which are digitally, which are about scaling up digital technologies. Once we identified these 14 innovators, we facilitated partnership between these innovators and 16 county governments. The idea was very simple. How can we ensure that these startups come together and provide bundled services on the ground to the farmers and thus solve the last mile service delivery problem? And this was a partnership which I would define as a win-win-win partnership. For the farmers, it meant that they would be able to access services right at their doorstep by leveraging digital technology. For the county governments, it meant improving their last mile service delivery. And for the startups, it meant that they were able to increase their outreach quite easily because their farmer acquisition cost was coming down as that was being done by the bank projects. The first example is that of an agtech startup called DigiCow, which is owned by a woman entrepreneur. This offers an app that provides 24-hour timely, reliable information, access to dairy farmers. What does this app provide? A, it enables farmers to access a variety of services like AI services, vaccination. They access a digital training room. They have access to online experts and also access to a chat room whereby they can learn about innovations being tried out by other farmers. It also offers a very simple interface where farmers can keep records and get real-time and simple access to analytical reports so that they can understand what their profitability is. Another example I'd like to quote is an agtech startup called TrueTrade, which is providing access to markets for farmers. They have a web and mobile-enabled trading and payment platform, which brings together a network of agents and farmers. And once these two come together, a price is agreed upon and quality is agreed upon, the farmers are able to sell directly to these marketers. And therefore, farmers are able to access far-off markets. Additionally, as soon as the sale happens, the agent triggers a digital payment and farmers receive the payment directly into their bank account through mobile money. To conclude, I would say that this initiative has demonstrated a model which has excited A, the public sector, B, the private sector, the agtech ecosystem, other development partners, and most importantly, farmers. Thank you so much.